Beloved Gurudev is the sunlight of our life. Beloved Gurudev is the sunrise of wisdom from within. Beloved Gurudev was an embodiment of old age that he considered as the golden age of human life. Let us pray and bow. Our beloved Gurudev, Sri Guruji, and masters of the lineage, and all masters of world religions of all places and times. We are in the midst of sacred celebrations of Gita Jayanti, birthday of Srimad Bhagavad Gita. Let us pray and bow to Mother Gita, Lord Sri Krishna, and the most beautiful disciple, Sri Arjuna. On this beautiful day, we should think of Gita, God, and Gurudev to fight old age, to overcome the unwarranted panic because of the old age. Each one and his life is a life of old age. 1 hour old little child, 1 month old, 1 year old, 10 year old, 30 years old, 100 years old. It is a beautiful journey of old age from the beginning to the end. World is becoming old. Life in the world is becoming old. So why worry? On this beautiful occasion, when the new year is coming, 22 will be departing very soon, and 2021 will be arriving very soon. Let us greet both of them, once for its beautiful departure, and the other's beautiful arrival, seeking new hope, new love, new life, new aspiration, peace and joy in the world. Today's topic, problems and prospects of old age. Most of us, when you think of the old age, they get panicked. What will happen to me? What will happen? Day by day, the physical disabilities are growing. It's true, with the old age, the physical strength of the youth disappears. The physical strength of the young man disappears. But another strength emerges, a new strength to take up the cause of old age. Old age, fighting the old age. I would rather say enjoying the old age. We should have more knowledge, more wisdom to enjoy, use, and utilize the old age. Old age is a welcome thing, welcome feature, brilliant feature, colorful feature. Old looks beautiful. Old is brilliant. After years of penance, the old gathers experiences. The old moves on earth as a moving encyclopedia of knowledge and information. He is the spirit of joy and a spirit of inspiration. Old man, old woman, every hair should be respected. It is not very difficult to catalog the normal visible difficulties, disabilities of the old age, like loneliness, strengthlessness, dullness, visionless, toothlessness, helplessness, sickness, and forgetfulness, and many other things. But there are visible aspects. But the world is not really that represents helplessness. On the other hand, it represents hopefulness. Beloved Gurudev looked up in old age, something beautiful. If you look to some of the sayings of beloved Gurudev, we can, even me and all can understand the reality behind the old age. He used to bless his disciples to live 100 years, complete a century. Why? If old is not good, if old is a burden, if old is a misfortune, why our beloved Gurudev should bless disciples to live for 100 years, happy 100 years, holy 100 years? Baba knew that old is gold. He knew that disrespecting the old is disrespecting the God. He recognized the old as the soul of the society, lighthouse of the people. The purity of the childhood, child growing in the lap of the mother, the organized effort for earning in the youth, intelligence, and some amount of introspection, enterprise, that of the adulthood. All these virtues, they are beautifully reflected in old age. For the cause of evolving a harmonious life, they can bind generations. The old is a bond, is a link between the gun and the coming up, the past and the future. Old is so beautiful. It's a link. It's a visible link, a very vital link between the past and the future. Looking to these situations of the human life, the various stages of human life, I mean the physical growth and the intellectual growth. Our ancient ancestors considered human life, or considering human life as a span of 100 years, divided them into four equal parts of 25 years each. First, to be devoted for study, studentship, based on discipline, physical and mental regulations, as well as freedom. No regulation without freedom can be considered as a beautiful regulation. The second, Garyastha, householder's life, leading a life of living, earning, forming a family, having husband and wife and children, seeking happiness inside the home, making that home in heaven, serving everybody, like a banyan tree, giving shade, shelter to many people, poor and needy. Third page, Vanaprastha. Not necessary to leave the home. Living inside the home, one can lead the life of a Vanaprastha. That's the beginning of renunciation. A life devoted to the cause of surrender, service. A beautiful life of service, selfless service. Life that is called Vanaprastha. Delimiting the needs, delimiting the desires, delimiting the aspirations, but making the desire for God unlimited, making the desire for breath consciousness, guru consciousness, unlimited, infinite, abandoning the questions of finite and seeking infinite, that is Vanaprastha. Whatever that I have earned in the past, whatever they have gathered in the past, I must give it up. Or necessarily I must reduce its store, distribute in a charitable way among the poor and the needy. The knowledge, the wisdom that I have acquired must be shared with others. The virtues that I have must be distributed among others. Let me not die a rich. Let me die a non-possessing human being. All my possessions may be distributed among the people for the cause of their welfare, their happiness, my happiness. Then the fourth stage, sannyasa, complete renunciation, either within the home or without. Further delimiting, further dissociating myself from the desires, demands, designs, dreams, completely dreamless, desireless, thinking of only one, Atman, Paramatman, Brahman, through the Guru Narayan. This is the question. Can we attain all these things in this life? Why not? All practitioners of Kriya Yoga, like you and me, we can rededicate ourselves to that cause, that we shall live 100 years happily pursuing yoga, as has been taught by our beloved Gurudev and Sri Guruji. One pursuit of the God, pursuit of happiness of the people around me, that's the only pursuit. And that what sannyas demands of. There are people in this world, they're practicing sannyas, remaining within the householder's life. That is why Sri Guruji once said us, a successful householder is far more greater than four monks put together. Importance lies not in the color of your dress. Importance lies in the color of your thought, color of your heart, color of your karma, the activity. Now coming to some of the list of the problems and little analysis. Man becomes very lonely during old age. It is said, for the tree becomes old, leaves are no more there, so birds desert them. Birds would not stay there. That will not be giving shades anymore. So the travelers, they will not sit beneath such a dry branch of the trees, bereft of the green leaves. But really, old man is not like that. Why do you think that way? Old man in his old age has to bring about a harmony, a balance between seeking the company of the human beings and seeking the company of the God. When the company of the fellow men becomes a little bit, say, feeble, then the company of the God becomes stronger, more beautiful, more mirthful. We landed on earth alone. We shall live the earth alone. Life, a journey of a lonely person. Old age is to cultivate this beautiful sense of solitariness, if I coin a word, spirit of a solitary reaper, going by myself, old age teaches us. So where is that pain, where is the pang of the loneliness at all? If I am with the breath, I am with the feelings of the presence of my beloved Gurudev, where is the loneliness? In the nature around me, I am to feel the presence of the God. Nature is embracing me, that is the embrace of the Lord. Where is the loneliness? I must look at my youngsters. I must look at my successors as my loving presence, and in them I shall find my presence, and in them I shall find a sense of continuity. They are the companions. Apart from that, good thoughts, good ideas, good feelings, good imaginations, they are the best companions. So where the man left alone? Man is never left alone. Man feels unnecessarily that he is alone and buries himself under the load of loneliness and cries. To think of the nectar, that the nectar that the teachings of beloved Gurudev is giving to us. Let us drink. Drink that nectar. Feel the presence of Gurudev everywhere. As Yogananda felt the presence of Jogiraj in that beautiful photograph, living image of the Lord. We are too. We are always in the company of the God and the Guru. People feel that I'm becoming strengthless. Oh, strengthlessness. No. That strength of the youth is gone. Let me not run. I, as a resident of Harihara and the Gurukulam, I may not run towards the Konark and reach in time there. I can walk. If I cannot run, if cannot walk, I can make a Konark in poetry. I can make a Konark in philosophy. I can make a Konark in my paintings. That is the spirit of the old age. Where is the lack of strength? Lack of strength doesn't mean that I cannot run. I can do many things, sitting at home, working in the table, working with the table, working indoor. When outdoor activities are restricted, indoor activities are now expanded. So where is strengthlessness? I may not lift like a lifter. I may not say fight like a boxer. I may not run like a marathon racer, but I can. A marathon racer in my mind. I can enjoy the colors of the thought. I can reflect them in my writing. I'll convert the physical strength into mental strength. I'll convert the strength of my body into the strength of my heart, the strength of my meditation, strength of my breath. So where is strengthlessness? People feel that old age is a question of dullness. Why? Rather, old age is beautiful, full of colors. If in the youth, adulthood, I have failed to see the sunrise every morn, now the time to enjoy the sunrise and the sunset. Now to collect the colors from there. And now to see the rainbow and enjoy the colors. Life is not dull. If I wish I can make it dull, but God has given a life full of beauty, full of colors. We unnecessarily make it dull and drab. Whenever mind is not happy, read good books, enjoy, sing songs. I remember I was very fortunately connected to a family in Orisha. The old man was a singer and a beautiful musician, and his wife was a dancer. I saw he playing the music and singing the song, and the wife is dancing at the old age. What a beautiful couple, whiling away the old age in dancing in joy. Can't we enjoy our old age the like? Where is dullness? Dullness in the mind, not in the body. At home, at workplace, everywhere I can become brilliant, colorful, make others happy, lead them in a happy life. Yes, some people feel old age will become visionless, will become teethless. No, nothing of the sort. Medical science has come up to our health. They can give us new eyes, new lenses, and medically suited artificial teeth. But I am not talking of that. If you forget the truth, you become toothless. Sri Guruji was telling us one day, look at the two sets of the teeth, guarding the tongue, guarding the tyranny of the tongue in two sectors. Tyranny of the tongue in test, tyranny of the tongue in talks. Two sets of teeth are guarding them. And when we fail to guard the tongue, we become toothless. And when cannot see the things, the real, then we are visionless. The real spectacle, the spectacle of meditation, the inner eye, the inner strength of vision, to visualize the presence of the Brahman here, there, everywhere. Seeker of truth and becoming visionless. What an alarming loss. What an alarming fall. Old age teaches us to cultivate, to have a new vision, vision of the Brahman through meditation, following the path of the Sri Gurudev and Sri Guruji. Toothless. Men in youth and adulthood somehow, sometimes may lose their freedom because of their employment, because they are afraid of losing this or that. But the old, there's nothing to gain, nothing to lose. At least this is the time that you can speak honestly like an editor of a newspaper. You can speak honest like a master, as a teacher. Old men can say, halt, don't go that way, my children. Come with me, proceed this way, my children. This is the path to the hell, this is the path to the heaven. If old man and old woman so neglect this duty of telling the truth, speaking the truth, guiding the future generation, then that man or that woman becomes visionless, toothless. If you look at another aspect, helplessness. Why helplessness? Old age, rather, is an age of hopefulness. Sri Guruji was telling me on that day, it is the old age, the real life starts. From 51 to 100, that is the real life. One should enjoy the real life day by day, hour by hour, month by month. Helplessness. Think of the help. Help coming from the scriptures. Help coming from the masters. Help coming from the God. This is the time to cultivate, to seek help, assistance from the three great helpers. Scripture, God, and the Gurus. No old man can complain that I don't have any time to meditate, no time to pray. I have many things to do otherwise. Old man, full of hope, full of truth, full of joy, full of work. I, when retired as a teacher from my college teaching days, I thought of enjoying my retired life only with rest and relaxation, leisurely life. Aristocratic life. Oh, what a feeling. Sri Guruji told me on the first day of joining Gurukulam, retired life is full of work, full of love. On that very day, on the day I joined Gurukulam, I was about to retire around 10 o'clock night. Sri Guruji sailed into my room and said, wake up, young man. Can you draft a letter to be circulated among all the devotees and disciples, regarding the coming celebration of the birth centenary of our beloved Gurudev. I volunteered. I now continue on that day. Oh, my life is not to retire and rest. My life has retired from different job. Now I'm employed with another kind of job. Seeking a job, seeking a task, seeking some kind of service is a necessity to keep old age full of joy. And that is a thing that one should learn from Sri Guruji. Time consciousness. One who is time conscious, one is devoted to work, one after the other, he can follow the master properly. Where is the time to lament? Where is the time to cry? Where is the time to weep? And this is how old age is to be understood. Whenever I have thought of thinking of old age, I always think of a song that is a very inspiring song of social service. Manasa satatam smaraniyam, vachasa satatam badaniyam, lokahitam mama karaniyam. In my thought, in my mind, in my words, I will think of service to fellow men. I will speak of service to fellow men every moment in my life. Let my life be devoted to the cause of the people, the cause of the society. Nabhoga bhavane ramaniyam, nacha sukha sayane sayaniyam, aharnisham jagaraniyam, nabhoga bhavane ramaniyam. Let me no more roll my life in luxuries, nothing beyond the necessities, no comforts any further. Nacha sukha sayane sayaniyam, not to count my fortunes of the past. Let me not think of the goodness, I mean the possessions of property and marks of prosperity in my life. I should forget. I should think of what? I should think of only the future of the world, future of the loving generations, young youth. Aharnisham jagaraniyam, janisa sarvabhutanam tasam jagrati sanjami. I should not sleep like the others. I should keep myself wake up. I must be always in alert condition to look to the majority of others, sorrows and sadness of others. Najatu dukkham gananiyam. I let me not count my misfortune, my sorrows and sadness. Nachanija saukhyam mananiyam. Let me also think of my fortunes. Karya khetre twaraniyam. I was really very, say, delaying in nature, procrastinating, delaying. Okay, I shall do it tomorrow. I'll take up tomorrow. Being brushed every moment by the beautiful rebuke of my Guruji, I have lost that bad quality by more than 60%, yet to be cleaned. Do it, the work here and now, today, to complete the work. Taraniyam, I must be very quick and prompt in disposing the things. Dukkha sagare taraniyam. God, I would love to swim in the sea of sorrows. I shall have no feelings. I must go for the other way. I must sail into the ocean of happiness the other way. Gahana ranne anandakare bandhu janaye sthita gauvare tatramaya sang charaniya. Gahana Aranya, in the deep, in the forest of dense forest of Saroj, the dense forest of the darkness where my people are suffering, I am to go there, assist them, help them, cooperate them, to lift them from a level of suffering to a level of, say, mirth and beauty. I greet all of you on behalf of the old men and old women, the community of the old age, to the youngsters, don't worry about the old age. Follow the God and Gurus, follow the scriptures. Nothing will happen to you when you attain old age. It will be beautiful and brilliant. May God bless us all. We'll now meditate. Let us sit silently. Slowly making the body temple as a temple of Gita, temple of scriptures. Deep concentration at the top of the head. Every moment, feeling the presence of beloved Gurudev. Living on the earth with the earth, but seeking God, seeking breath every moment. More breath consciousness will help us to dissolve earth consciousness. Remaining in breath consciousness, let us inhale, hold, and bow to Gurudev, God and Mother God. Exhale. Normal consciousness. Prayer for making life beautiful, youth beautiful, adulthood beautiful, and the future old age beautiful. That is the demand of yoga. That will be the result of Kriya consciousness. Inhale, hold, sit up. Exhale. Normal conscious breathing. Think within. Dream within, Gita, Bible, Quran, all coming together, merging into one. One. Love, peace, joy. You are inhaling loving teachings of Gurudev. Pause, assimilating them. Exhaling doubts of life. Again, inhaling teachings of Gita. Pause, assimilating. Exhaling depression from the mind. Keep on inhaling with the pause, exhaling in Guru consciousness. The more you are conscious of the breath, the more I am conscious of my breath. Breath will become beautiful. Make your body and mind beautiful. It will make our life, family, ashram beautiful, world beautiful. Breath behind all beauty, all success, all achievement. Gurudev used to say, through breath, transformation. Deep concentration within. Kriya is a fire ceremony. Every loving breath is an oblation. Purifying our emotions, purifying our feelings, fire of the fire ceremony, illuminating within, inhale deep, hold, merge, exhale deep, continue. Our body and mind to become suitable for higher kriya attainments. Only through practice and prayer only through service to God and Gurudev. Today, the birthday of Gita that happened around 5,000 years ago in a place nearer to New Delhi of India today. That battleground of Mahabharata. A great dialogue between a great teacher and a great student did take place of that journey. The essence, the nectar came out in the form of Gita. Let us pledge to become Gita person. Let us place the mind and the body to become a Gita temple tomorrow. Perfect temple of Gita. Step by step, chapter by chapter, we'll climb to the summit of Nirvana. Through Kriya. Now, inhale deep, hold, bow to Gurudev, to God, to Gita, and exhale. Normal, conscious breathing. Lokahitam mama karaniyam. Before to old age, during the old age, I will dedicate myself to the cause of the common welfare. Inhale, hold, sit up. Exhale, remaining in normal conscious breathing, embrace the feelings of the Lord, teachings of the Gurudev and Gita. Offer love to 2020 and offer a new year greeting to 2021. I bow to all of you, remembering divine images of the Lord and our beloved Gurudev. Om, Amen, Jai Guru.